Good morning, children. Now we have completed all the different types of habitats of the plant and the plant types also. We have discussed their morphological features, morphological adaptations. We have discussed about their anatomical adaptation, and we have discussed about their physiological adaptations also. Now last part we have come, that is called the dispersal of fruits and seeds. We know little bit, we are having the idea, because from 10th standard we are studying that fruits and seeds possess attractive color, odor, shape, taste needed for the dispersal by different types of agents, mainly the animals. In addition to that, some abiotic factors are also responsible for the dispersal of fruits and seeds. We know the seed contains the embryo. Since what are the three parts are there of a seed? The embryo will be there, reserve food material will be there, that is stored food material, and third part is called the protective layers, which is called the seed coat. As the seeds contain miniature but dormant future plants, the dispersal is essential. Otherwise, future plants will be not developed or produced. So we can see that their dispersal is an important criterion for distribution and establishment of plants over a wide geographical area. Why wide geographical area it should be dispersed? Now if the seeds are accumulating in a particular place, the competition will be arising, and that will be very much detrimental, harmful to the plants. That's why seeds to be dispersed in wide geographical area, so the survivability of their existence will be more, chances of survivability will be more. So seeds to be dispersed. The dissemination or the dispersal of seeds and fruits to various distances from the parent plant is called the seed and fruit dispersal. It takes place with the help of ecological factors, that are also abiotic factors, maybe water, maybe wind, maybe animals also. Seed dispersal is a regeneration process of plant population and a common means of colonizing new areas to avoid seedling level competition. That one I told you should be dispersed. If all the seeds are falling in the same place, competition will be arising, so they may not survive. A survivability of those seeds, of these plantlets or seedling stage will be very tough. And from natural enemies like herbivores, frugivores and the pathogens. Fruit maturation and dispersal and seed dispersal is influenced by many ecologically favorable conditions such as season, suitable environment, seasonal availability of dispersal agents like birds, insects, etc. So these are the biotic and abiotic factors or the agents are responsible for the dispersal of fruits and seeds. Seeds require agents for dispersal which are crucial in plant community dynamics in many ecosystems. They offer many benefits to the communities such as food and nutrients, migration of seeds across habitats and helping spreading plant genetic diversity. Now next one, dispersal. One by one we will be discussing dispersal by wind. Dispersal by wind, already we know the term is called anemochory. The individual seeds or the whole fruits may be modified to help for the dispersal by wind. Wind dispersal of fruits and seeds is quite common in tall trees. Adaptation, what type of adaptation we can see in the fruits and seeds which are dispersed by wind? First one is minute seeds. Seeds should be very small and lightweight also. Seeds are minute, very small, lightweight, with inflated coverings, wing-like structures also will be there. Example is orchid, minute seeds. Number two, wings. Seeds of whole fruits are flattened to form a wing so that it can fly in the air. Maple, Gyrocarpus, Dipterocarpus, Terminalia, all these plants are having the wing-like structure so it can fly in air for dispersal. The next one is called feathery appendages. So just like seeds and fruits may have feathery appendages, which greatly increase the buoyancy to disperse to various altitudes. Bernonia, Asclepias, Tridax, we are seeing. Asclepias. Sensor mechanism. The fruits of many plants open in such a way that the seeds can escape only when the fruit is violently shaken by the strong wind. That is called sensor mechanism. Fruits of many plants open in such a way that the seeds can escape only when the fruit is violently shaken. Bursting will be taking place. So the by a strong wind. Strong wind will be responsible for the breaking of the seed coat, fruit coat. So the seeds will be come out. Will be coming out. Example, Aristolochia, poppy, all these are. Next one, dispersal by water, Hydrochory. Dispersal of seeds and fruits by water usually occurs in those plants which grow in or near water bodies. Adaptations of Hydrochory, obconical receptacle with prominent air spaces. Example is Nilambo. Obconical receptacle. Receptacle will be not opposite to that of the conical shape. So with prominent air spaces so that it can float in water and it can reach the distant places. Nilambo. Number two, presence of fibrous mesocarp and light pericarp. Already we used to say that is called coconut. Seeds are light, small, provided with airy leaf which encloses air. That is, we can see in nymphia. Aerial means with aerial, that is a edible part, and will be the seeds will be embedded in a thalamus, which is called the, which is spongy in nature, where you can see in nymphia. The fruit may be inflated, flattened. Hereditaria littoralis. The fruit may be inflated, flattened shape so that it can swim, it can float in water. Seeds by themselves would not float, may be carried out by water current. Example is coconut. Now dispersal by animals, which is called, another term is called zoochory. Birds and mammals, including human beings, play an important role in the dispersal of fruits and seeds. They have the following devices. What are the devices? Now, first one is called the hooked fruit. With that hook, it will be, and the fruit or seed will be fixed to the fur of animals or to the clothes of human beings. So, whenever human being will move from one place to another place, these fruits and seeds also will be dispersed. Same way, animals also. Surface of the fruits and seeds have the hooks, xanthium, birds, andropogon, spines, Aristidia, by means of which they adhere to the body of animals, the fur of animals, and the clothes of human beings, and get dispersed. Now, sticky fruits and seeds. Some fruits have sticky glandular hairs by which they adhere to the fur of grazing animals and they disperse. Example, Boerewia cleome. Some fruits have viscid layer which adhere to the beak of birds which eat them, and when they rub them on the branch of the tree, they disperse and germinate. Example is Cordia and Alangium. Fleshy fruits. Some fleshy fruits with conspicuous colors are dispersed by human beings to distant places after consumption. Suppose mango. Diplocyclos. Dispersal by explosive mechanism, that one we know in impatience balsamina, that means balsam plant. So some fruits burst suddenly with a force enabling to throw the seeds to a little distance away from the plant. Autochory shows the following adaptations. Mere touch of some plants causes the ripened fruit to explode suddenly and the seeds are thrown out with great force. Impatience, balsam plant. Next, some fruits, when they come in contact with water, particularly that one used to play the game also. Come in contact with the water, particularly after a shower of rain, burst suddenly with a noise and scatter the seeds. Druellia, Crossandra. Certain long pods explode with a loud noise like crackers, scattering the seeds in all directions. Bauhinia Wallii, camel's foot climber it is called. As the fruits mature, tissues around seeds are converted into mucilaginous fluid, due to which a high target pressure develops. As the that is called pericarp. As the fruit matures, tissues around the seeds are converted into mucilaginous fluid, due to which, because of this mucilaginous fluid, a high target pressure develops inside the fruit, which leads to the dispersal of seeds. Example, Egbalium. Egbalium elatrium, that means squatting cucumber. Squatting, this is a squatting cucumber. Gyrocarpus and Dipterocarpus. Now next one is human aided seed dispersal, that is called seed ball. Very, very important that one. What do you mean by seed ball? Seed ball is an ancient Japanese technique of encasing seeds in a mixture. The seeds will be placed inside this capsule, like covering. Covering is made up of clay and soil humus, cow dung, and scattered them onto a suitable ground, not planting up trees manually. So what will happen? Whenever the seeds will be getting the suitable condition, rainwater will be coming from these seeds. And humus is also there, nutrients are there, fertilizers are also there. They will grow automatically. So ancient Japanese technique of encasing seeds in a mixture of clay and humus and scattering them on a suitable ground, not planting up trees manually. This method is suitable for barren and degraded lands of tree regeneration and vegetation before monsoon period to be scattered, where the suitable dispersal agents become rare. So that is the way in barren land also we can develop the vegetation by this method, and it is an ancient Japanese technique by which seeds can be dispersed by the human being, which is called the seed ball. Okay, thank you children. This is the end of the topic.